I've been in this business 25 years, and the plants I've worked at, they've never stopped growing. And I guess part of that's because Las Vegas is growing. Wastewater surveillance came to us here at the district back in March of 2020. Since then, we have collected over 1,000 samples, because samples are so vital to providing the data to get out in front of outbreaks. What happens here is, before we start to treat the water, we're going to sample it, and then we'll send it to Verily.
With typical clinical surveillance, it's reliant first on someone feeling that they're sick, second on them going and deciding to get tested, and third, how long does it take for that test to be run and reported. Whereas here at Verily, with just a single sample of wastewater, we can gain incredible insights into what pathogens are present and at what levels.
Wastewater surveillance is a portal into the community. With the results that we get from Verily, all the data is laid out to be able to present it to our public health officials.
Yeah, you can come out here and see the secondary clarifier.
So that they can understand what diseases might be out there to keep that community safe, keep them healthy, and keep their family healthy without them having to do anything.
Some of these wastewater treatment plants are large. The biggest 500 capture wastewater from 50% of the U.S. population. So just by testing samples from this relatively small number, we can gain insight into what's happening across the country. It's a vast resource that's key to understanding population-level health.
Las Vegas is a wonderful place for wastewater surveillance because not only do we have 2.5 million residents here in the Las Vegas Valley, on any given day, we have 300,000 tourists. And wastewater surveillance is another way to contribute to the health and welfare of this community.
By choosing the sampling locations around Southern Nevada, we can tap into what's happening on the Strip specifically, and then what's happening in the broader community. And what we've seen in the past is that when we look at the Strip, sometimes we see that signal a lot faster because it's happening elsewhere in the world first. Microbiology is inherently variable. But when we started doing wastewater surveillance, what was crazy to me was how accurate it was. It was spot on. Now we know that this works. Public health officials are ready to adopt this tool and this technology to be able to set up mobile vaccination clinics to administer vaccines in places where there was a high priority for that.
We can gain insights into communities ranging from the tens of thousands in population up to the millions.
The possibilities are endless. Every time something happens throughout the world in terms of a new disease that's emerging, there's potential for wastewater surveillance to fill a data gap and address those public health needs.